and provided everything that I was in need of, God. We just want to say thank you. God, we thank you for looking out over us, because we know that there's been times where we didn't see danger that was lurking around the corner, but God, you steered us in this different direction to keep us away from that harm, oh God, and we just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
God, you've been so good to us. Your record is impeccable. Your attendance is perfect, because every time we needed you, God, you was there, and we just got to say thank you.
Thank you.
God, we come to you now. We come to you now around your throne of grace, God, because there's somebody here who needs you, O Lord. God, we've had some expressions of those who have some special needs, and Lord, we don't know all of their situations, and it's not for us to know, but we know that you know everything about what's going on, oh God. Where there is some need for some healing, oh God, we pray that you manifest yourself right now. Where there's need of some comfort, oh God, for the bereaving family, we pray that you put your arms around them and let you know that you're there to lift up a bound out head, oh God. When there is somebody who has some financial straits, God, we know that you're able, God, to provide everything they need. God, whatever we stand in need of, you can do it. We know you can, oh God. We know. We've got proof, oh God. Your history has showed every time we needed you, oh God.
Yes.
You was there, and we just have to say thank you.
Thank you.
God, we pray, oh God, for all of these families who are represented today. We pray, Father, that you just could continue to help all of us to grow closer to you.
For
we know if we grow closer to you, God, then everything might not work out the way we want, but we know that we've got you and everything will be all right, oh God. As long as we keep our hand in your hand, we know that everything will be all right. God, we come to you now praying for the pastor of this flock that you have placed here, oh Lord. We thank you, oh God, first and foremost for putting him in our lives, oh God. We thank you for his leadership. We thank you for his direction. We thank you for all that you have given him to do with us and for us and through us, oh God. And we just pray for him and his family, that you just continue to give them strength that they can do the work that you have called them to do, oh God. Pray for his family, that they continue to support him, his wife and his daughters and his son, and to just help them to continue to lift him up, Father, that he can do the work that you have him to do.
Yes.
God, we pray for the people of God that you placed in his leadership, that we might be receptive to the things that you're giving him to teach us, oh God, for we have to be open to his leadership, oh God, and let us know that as he follows you, we can follow him and everything will be all right. God, we pray for the remainder of this service, oh God. We pray, Father, that you just continue to manifest yourself, oh God. We pray, Father, that you remove anything that might hinder us from worshiping you. Remove any hatred we might have. Remove any bad feelings in our hearts we might have. Remove any spite or any selfishness, Father, that you might be glorified, oh God. We thank you, God, for this chance, because there's some people don't even have the ability to worship you. So we thank you, oh God, for having a place where we can come and worship and praise you, for you are so worthy to be praised. God, we pray for the man of God that's going to break the bread of life today. Give him preaching power, oh God, that he might preach an uncompromising gospel, Father, that there might be some man, woman, boy, or girl that might get up out of their seat and come crying, "What must I do to be saved?" Lord, we're not here for any shape, form, or fashion, but it's all that you might be glorified. So we pray, God, that you just continue to help us to be the light, Father, in this dark and dying world, oh God, that some people might come to the reality of serving the truth and living God. We thank you, oh God, and we just pray that you continue to lead, guard, and keep us, for we know that we can't do anything without you. In the mighty and wonderful name of Jesus, we pray and ask it all in the church today.
Amen.
Thank you.
I'm following the Holy Spirit. This has been heavy on my heart. We have a lot of things going on in the world today.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It can easily keep you bogged down. And I want to thank Mark for that other song. I want to play. Tomorrow's my promise to know that.
That's right, sir.
You got to do what the Lord tells you to do.
Yeah.
Right now. So I'm moving on the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Why should I feel discouraged?
Yes, yes.
And why should a shadow
His eyes
is on the
Christ our Lord and Savior. Father, for all that you do in my life.
Yes.
Just thank you for being the source of my supply, for being my supply.
Yes.
You just do it all, I understand. Ask now that you forgive me of my sins, forgive me of my unrighteousness.
Jesus.
I pray that you'll just have your way with me.
Yes.
Would you stand in my body and speak to my heart?
Yes.
Speak to my mouth. Things that you
yes.
Your people to hear this morning.
Yes.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, thy strength,
yes.
And thy
yes.
Amen.
This is my prayer.
Amen.
You only like pastor now, you turn my mic down.
Tap one.
Yes, we have to do it.
Amen.
If you would you turn to Luke chapter 20? Luke chapter 10. And he said unto him, thou hast answered right. This do and thou shalt live.
Right.
But he willing to testify himself, said unto Jesus, and who is my neighbor?
Well, right.
And Jesus said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho,
yep.
And fell among thieves, which stripped him from his raiment, and wounded him, and departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise, a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was. And when he saw him, he had compassion on him. And he went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and setting him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn and took care of him. And on the morrow when he was departed, he took out 2 pences and gave them to the host, and said unto him, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee.
Amen.
Which now of these three thinkest thou was neighbor to him that fell among thieves? And he said, he that showed mercy on him.
Amen.
Then said Jesus unto him, go and do likewise.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me see.
Amen.
For a thought, we'd like to use, what in the world does a Christian do? Now, the question that the scribe asked was a good question. What shall I do to inherit eternal life? Those are questions that preachers, pastors, and disciples love to hear, and deacons. What must I do in this thing? But the lawyer's motive was wrong. He was trying to trap Jesus into something.
Yeah. All right.
And he was trying to get him into a debate about who is my neighbor.
Wow.
Now, I'm blessed. I have 2 great neighbors.
Amen.
Well, 2 families of great neighbors. I got Thomas and Cheryl to my west, and I got Connie and Rob to my right. But those are my neighbors, and I can count on them.
Right. Amen.
Now. All right.
But the word neighbor goes farther than that.
Okay, talk to him, man.
The neighbor are those ones we meet as we go.
All right.
Yes. You know, back over there in Matthew 28, it talks about go ye therefore and make disciples. So, in other words, as you go.
All right.
So, as we go, we see more neighbors. We have more neighbors. Now, Jesus sent the lawyer back to the law. Now, to us, that doesn't make sense because we know the law can't save us, right?
All right.
But the law shows us that we need to be saved.
Right.
That's what the law is really all about.
All right.
So the lawyer really knows, but now he's trying to make an excuse. He's trying to justify himself when really he should have just threw himself on God's mercy and said,
you really help know, me. Mike. Come on, preach.
He knows what he's supposed to do.
All right. Wow. Yeah.
There can be no conversion without a conviction.
All right.
And the law is what God uses to convict us. And if you look at Romans 3:20, it tells you that. But we get on down into the text and we see this man that has been robbed. He's been beaten. And the priest looks on at him from a distance. He doesn't even go over and say anything to him. He doesn't even say, I'll sit back, help.
Mm-hmm.
But he just goes on his way.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Now, if you read about this road from Jerusalem to Jericho, it's a very dangerous road.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
It's not straight. It's rocky, it's got cliffs, little knolls that you can hide in.
Yeah.
And if you're in the right position, you can see either way if anyone else is coming.
Yeah.
Perfect.
And they're lurking in the dark.
That's right.
Yeah.
Even though it's daylight, it's darkness because of where their mind is. And they jump out and they pounce on this man. They take, and then they're gone. It's just like they disappeared. Yeah. So if anybody's coming, they don't see nothing.
Yes.
It's a shame that these priests and this Levite, who are supposed to be God's ministers and doing the things that would be in the temple.
That's right, sir. Mm-hmm.
All right.
But you know, we have those in today's world too.
All right.
They will